Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Exodus 24:6. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven above or on the earth beneath or in the waters below. 5. You shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the parents to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me, 6. But showing love to 1,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. Today's title is the Second Commandment. We have seen in the overview that the Ten Commandments is God's marriage proposal to us. In other words, it is God's love letter for us. God's passionate and fervent love for his people is saturated in all the commandments, whether it is explicitly said or not. I believe such passionate love of God is even more visible in this second commandment. He says, I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God. In other words, he says that I am a person with a loving heart and I care if your love for me is faithful and sincere. Who feels jealous and why? We feel jealous when we love someone or something so passionately that we want them exclusively. When we want such exclusive love, it is granted that we offer our exclusive love for them too. Marriage is a typical example of such love. No wonder why God said that he wanted to be our husband through this covenant. God first promised and performed such devotional love for us. Then he is requesting the same devotion from us, for he knows how easily we people are distracted by our sinful nature. The sinful man is hopelessly selfish and egotistic. Man corrupted by sin is inclined to do everything for their own satisfaction and in their own ways. They are ceaselessly pulled and pushed by their own lust for the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. Out of such sinful nature, people are often tempted to make idols for themselves and they indulge in those idols. Having fervent and passionate love for his people, God cannot overlook making and worshipping such self-satisfying idols of the people who are supposed to be his pure and holy bride. Such betrayal prompts my anger, for I love you dearly, God says. But your love and faithfulness prompt my blessings exceedingly more. Our God is the God of love. He is love. Have you ever received and felt such intense and passionate love of God? Of course, we all have. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. I mean, he gave his own life for us to demonstrate his love for us. Why would he not be provoked to anger if we still flirt with other lovers that are not in any way comparable to him? Do you feel the passionate heart of God for you? Yes. God loves you to the point of sacrificing his own life. Is it too much if he exhorts you to live worthy of his love? Of course not. I believe that's the point of this commandment.